One of the topics that comes up most on this channel is my home park, Six Flags St. Louis. But it was recently brought to my attention that I have never ranked rides in this park, excluding my top 20 coasters video. I wanted to make a top 10 coasters, but since we don't have that many coasters, I instead decided to extend it out and create a video on my top 15 rides at Six Flags St. Louis. This list will include everything: flats, water rides, coasters, and dark rides, except our dark ride failed to make the list. With that said, let's begin. Number 15. Shazam, a classic scrambler ride. There isn't too much to say about Shazam, except that it's very fun. It pulls some excellent and decently comfortable laterals, and overall, I just always enjoy myself on it. My favorite experience on it has to be riding it in 19 degrees Fahrenheit weather though. Number 14. Ninja, an Aero and Vekoma custom looping coaster. I've said that I've hated Ninja a lot, but recently, I've been developing a bit of a soft spot for it. This has come with my newfound Aero love, so I have started to appreciate its jolts and imperfect profiling. It feels weird to say, but I kinda would be sad if Ninja were to get removed. It may not have the stats, intensity, airtime, laterals, or really anything on its side, but I just really enjoy Ninja for some reason. Number 13. The Joker, a swinging ship ride. This ride is a lot like Shazam for me. It doesn't have anything special or unique, but it's just very enjoyable. It had a short run as my favorite ride in the park a while back, and I really have started to enjoy it, even though it isn't super thrilling or anything. A ride in the back row gives some decent floater, and is made even better by the restraint that doesn't touch me. There's just something about the Joker that I really love. Number 12. Thunder River, an Intamin Rapids ride. This is another ride that was once my favorite, and I still enjoy it. It is an absolute soaker, and actually has a decent but subtle theme to it that I really like. There's a tunnel partway through that gets you more soaked than any other ride in the park now that Tidal Wave is gone, provided that you are sitting on the right side of the boat. The people in the boat are also very fun, because somehow it is always a competition to see who can stay the most dry, and who can get the wettest. Thunder River is just a whole lot of fun, plus it gives a coaster that I will talk about later an island setting. Number 11. The Log Flume. While it may not have any fancy name, huge drop, or thrilling element, I have so much fun on the Log Flume. I have some excellent memories on it, and along with that, it offers a decently fast and fun ride through the woods. Tack on the fact that the drop is one of the few to still give me the stomach feeling, and you've got one fun Log Flume. Number 10. The River King Mine Train, an Aero Mine Train. Here comes the big section of roller coasters, starting with the good old Mine Train. It is in second last for coasters, but that obviously doesn't mean I don't love it, based on how I've been talking about other rides. The Mine Train has a very fun, twisty layout through the woods, and for its age, it's actually fairly smooth for the most part. The surprise drop at the end is also great in the back row, offering strong floater with basically a metal buzz bar. Number 9. Pandemonium, a Gerstlauer spinning coaster. This coaster is a huge hit or miss for me. I've had rides with bone-crushing intensity, and I've had rides that felt like a monorail. Because of its inconsistency, this has always been one of the hardest coasters for me to rank, but today I put it here. It is a pretty fun ride experience with some good spinning and intensity, but it is a clone, and in the grand scheme of things, not that special at all. Number 8. Boomerang, a Vekoma Boomerang. I'm not a huge fan of boomerangs, but I'm also not a hater of them, and this is one that I actually quite enjoy. I have only ridden it once, but it was very smooth, had minimal headbanging, and was intense and very enjoyable. I'm not sure when I'll get back on it, as I'd much rather ride anything near it, but it wasn't too shabby. Number 7. Supergirl, a Zamperla Endeavor. It kinda hurts me to put this ride as high as I am, because I really am not too big of a fan of it, but I'm putting it here anyway because as much as I miss our Schwarzkopf Enterprise, it is fun. It's very open, but kinda boring, as it doesn't pull much force. I'll ride it if it doesn't have a line, but if it does, I'd much rather mourn the loss of the attraction it replaced, or go marathon the boss. Number 6. Batman the Ride, a B&M Inverted Coaster. This is another hit or miss coaster, as some days it runs super smooth and intense, and other days it's forceless and headache inducing. It's really good most of the time though, so I'll focus on that side and place it here. Batman is very fun. All of the inversions are snappy and intense, and it has a few turns and helices that make me gray out almost every time. It was also my second coaster ever to invert, so it has a sentimental value for me. Number 5. Screamin' Eagle, a PTC wooden coaster. What can I say about Screamin' Eagle except what a classic? I love Screamin' Eagle so much. Nothing quite matches a classic Woody going out and back through the woods with airtime the whole time. It has the full package. Laterals, floater, a moment of ejector, a perfect amount of roughness, and even some solid positives at points. Screamin' Eagle is just about a perfect ride, plus it has one of the best night rides I've ever had. Number 4. Superman Tower of Power, an Intamin drop tower. A short ride, but oh boy, wow, help me. The ride up is slow and builds anticipation, the view at the top is incredible as long as your gondola faces the park, and then the drop is insane. The ops generally like to troll you, so it comes out of nowhere, and man, what a drop. The airtime is amazing and it feels like such a long drop. I love Intamin drop towers, and Superman is a perfect example of why. Number 3. Mr. Freeze Reverse Blast, a Premier Rides launch shuttle coaster. This is by far the most intense and insane coaster at the park. Through every valley and turn, you get slammed into your seat with a massive amount of positive Gs. The inverted top hat is whippy, and depending on the day, either has nice positives or decent hang time. The overbank is super intense backwards, but easily gray out intense on the forward lap. The spike is insane, not because it's intense, but because you just keep on going up, and up, and up. And oh boy, we're going back down. Mr. Freeze's intensity is unmatched at the park, but it manages to remain enjoyable. Number 2. The Boss, a CCI wooden terrain coaster. I have a bit of history with this coaster. I used to hate it, but that changed in this past 2019 season. I was taught how to ride it, and oh boy, can you ride it. That airtime on the drop is insane. With enough room, you are literally standing. At the bottom, your restraint comes down with positives, but that doesn't stop the ejector you get on the next dips. That's about it for airtime, but the rest of the coaster is still packed with speed and crazy laterals. I know a lot of people who rank this as their number one in the park, and I can see why, but it just barely misses it for me. Before I get to the number one spot, I want to quickly give an honorable mention to Excalibur. I have always been too much of a baby to ride this thing, and when I finally told myself I would, it was down all season. However, I do have a friend that has ridden it, so I'll let him talk about it.
Okay, so Excalibur is a fun ride, but it's obviously not the best thing that you will ever experience, which is kind of obvious. It can get boring after you ride it the first few times though, which doesn't really bother me personally, but it's still fun. It's a little on the intense side, and by a little, I mean a lot. And it can make you pretty dizzy, so if you don't like stuff like that, then you might want to sit out.
Number 1. American Thunder, a GCI wooden coaster. Wow. This is one of the smallest coasters in the park, but don't let that skew your opinion. The drop flings you over the back with both ejector and laterals. There's nothing like it nearby. From there on out, you'll be in for a great layout full of great laterals and awesome floater. Sometimes. The time that American Thunder is truly number one with no contest is when it hauls, and I mean hauls. It speeds through the layout and gives a bunch of ejector that GCIs aren't even supposed to be capable of. American Thunder honestly is truly ridiculous, and I love it to pieces. That's it for my list of the top 15 rides at Six Flags St. Louis. Let me know in the comments what you thought of my list, and if you've been, feel free to tell me yours. Make sure to subscribe if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. By the way, if you want to watch me play Rocket League with another person, a video will be coming out tomorrow or Tuesday, so I'll be gaming in Nader27 channel. Go sub to him. Do it if you want to watch me game. Gaming. Sitting in the back, getting heated out my seat, rolling thunder.